So good evening to all of you. I hope all of you can hear me till the back. Okay. So my topic is FOSSMeet, past, present, and future. The motivation behind with this talk was history to be told. The people, those who forget the history, their culture no more exists. I'll tell you from where the FOSS started, especially in NIT Calicut. Two of the FOSS meets, I was a part of it in terms of organization. And the people who started before us, we are thankful and grateful to them. They took initiative and we got enlightened, and then we keep on passing that, whatever we learned, to the next generations. So I'll share with you a few of the things which we did it and what a student community should do it, or what are the further gap areas and so and so. So we'll try to identify. So what are the motivation is, first is history, documenting the FOSS experiment at NITC or around whatever is happening, identifying the gap areas, where we are missing in last 15 years, now we are in 15th edition, few things we have to still catch up, learning from the previous mistakes, documenting what are the good decisions happened or what are the things we will do for future, planning for future. And when we say planning for future, the one of the most important part of the future is community. We are all over here gathering as a community. Either it's a student community or a professionals community or faculty community or a government or administrators. We are all part of the community. Now, when we plan for a future, the importance over here lies everything with respect to the community. Community which collaborates. And believe me, if you have to build a community around it, our experience says that community can't be built without culture. Culture should be there. And culture should be thriving, which my understanding says a culture of sharing and caring should be built upon. Culture of contributions. Whenever you come forward, you don't say that what will it come for, what it has for me. You say that what I can contribute. Then, this contributions leads to the collaboration between the people. And the moment you collaborate, there mess always happens. Mess always happens. And then people bring a organizational structure around it. Like NIT Calicut has an organizational structure. All of you are coming from the different colleges and institutions. You have a different kind of organizational structures. But the moment you bring the structure, then something works and then something doesn't work. Even one of the best ideas also fall flat. I'll share a few of the examples which people did a good effort, and initially they started as a community, but the community was small. But the moment they tried to structure it, things started failing very badly. It means structure has something should be there that it should work, and the most important part is conventions. People forget that the structure, the conversation between you and me, the collaboration should be going by conventions rather than by configuration, rather by rules. I just give you one example. The FOSSMeet, which over here started with 2005, I took a charge of 2006 and 2007, then next generations on. We had a participation from first year, second year, third year, final year, and all. First year is always a challenge, especially over here in our campus, because we have one hostel, which is a hostel, which is a jail, we know that, right? And first year, you can't interact so easily because you are not allowed to go to them. Seniors are not allowed to go to them. Why? Because there is a tagline is called ragging. A moment because ragging is there, the ragging tagline is there, then even the good initiatives fall flat. People are not ready to take a courage to go, can I do it? Because nobody knows that when you will fall in that bracket, they will be regarded as ragging. Now this is an example. A simple example where the rule actually breaks the community. Where the rule breaks the community. Now if you go around in the campus, even in your campuses, it might be the same case. You'll see everywhere posters, ragging is an offense. Am I right? Now this is what the rule is. Rule is forced everywhere. But now comes a question. Is there is a other way around to propagate this idea that ragging is an offense without harming a community as such? where the collaboration happens between first year, second year, third year, fourth year together. Is it there is other way possible? Yes, there is other way possible. The possibility is based on the conventions, not based on the rules. You agree on some conventions that will take care of equal respect for our young people who are coming in a campus, equal opportunity, equal access to the knowledge and information. And the moment you agree on this convention, you promote to everybody, in your seniors and everybody, and even into the campus at administration level, I think most of the people actually adhere by conventions. Rarely somewhere one or two exceptions will come, but most of the people adhere by conventions. And what adhering a convention, they will actually force other people not to do anything wrong. That works better than by rule. Now comes a question, why this wisdom doesn't lie with administration? Why doesn't it lies with any of the government structure also? If you see that as a nation, there is a government structure because the approach is top down. And the moment you have approach is top down, it means it's a tree. Why we follow tree everywhere? Why organization structures are tree everywhere? Either it's a government or an institute or any, whatever the place you see, your file system is a tree. If you see your memory hierarchy, that is also treated as a tree. Everywhere you will see trees coming across. Why the tree is so obvious and everywhere exists in the organizational structure? With respect to computing, with respect to the social structure, with respect to the government structure, with respect to the administration structure, everywhere you'll see the tree. Is there any other way other than the tree? That's the question for all of you guys. And that's what we will discuss it. Shashi has raised a very interesting point. P2P Foundation is doing something interesting. And they are documenting a lot of wonderful stuff which already community has built on, which is collaboration. And collaboration is basically a graph. In Facebook, all of you are connected, right? I am there. I have 1,000 friends. They are further friend and all. If you mathematically you plot it, it's a graph. But our organizations are not graph. Our organizations are majorly tree. Now, question is why they go with the tree structure? Simply because dealing with the graph structure is very complex. It's a hard problem. It's not only a hard problem for optimization and all, it is a hard problem for management also. What the management theory says, a human can manage at the max 6 people. 6 persons means the 6 directly reporting to him, the 6 people have interaction between them, all the nuances, politics and other stuff, everywhere it happens. A manager can maximum only manage 6. If I had to manage a 140 people class, or this institute has to manage 5,000 students, obviously what will come? They can't go with the graph because there is a limit. There is a limit to the management complexity. Then you make a graph, tree. Okay, you have a director, then you have a dean, then you have a head of the departments, then you have a program coordinator or a course coordinator, then you have a faculty and so. But the moment you make a tree, why they make this tree? Because the cost of message transferring from top to bottom is the efficient. It's order of log n, right? Is there is better efficiency than this possible order of one? That's the second best possible choice you have. That's why most of the people go with the tree. But tragedy with the tree structure is, it kills communities. A community is which are grown up. Okay? Now what we have to learn, as a system, as a designer, that design should govern by conventions rather than by rules. And when we make rule, those are called design system designed by configurations. Rules can't change. Rules doesn't evolve. And generally, you people break rule. That's why what the most common saying is, rules are made to be broken. But conventions are not. Convention you don't break. Convention you evolve. If something doesn't fit in your convention, then you go back to the board again. See, okay, these are the 4 things we agreed on. Is the things, these are not catering to our need. Can we evolve to next level? Yes, we will evolve to next level. I hope it makes sense, right? So conventions are very, very important. So the moment you build a community, the community is governed by always a culture, and culture always governed by conventions. If you don't have a convention, believe me, that culture will now exist. Tomorrow it will not. Okay? And the moment you bring the conventions, okay, this contribution becomes profound by collaborations together. And the moment collaboration is there, then comes the continuity. And continuity is one of the toughest problem and hardest problem to solve. I give you examples. How many student project actually matured to a really a good project? How many students project really matured to a commendable good project? Take a statistics. I'll give you, it's not even more than 10%. And if you think it's a case with the local colleges only, no, it's a case with even IITs also. It doesn't lies with the mental facility. No, it's not related to the aptitude. It's not related to the ability. It's related to something other than this one. So student project doesn't mature to the next level. One of the important point is continuity is missing. Okay? Excuse me, please. Continuity is missing. Now, the moment you want to build a system anywhere, or a community anywhere, start thinking about the continuity from the day one. Now, one example of solving the continuity problem is, by rule, project should be done individually by a student. Most of the campuses follow that, right? Am I right or wrong? Rather, it should be other way around. Project can be collaborative. Some of the places, some of the projects are collaborative, but within a class, within a single batch. But that also doesn't work. Why? Suppose batch people are hardly 60 or 100 people. And the 60, 100 people are really very bright and intelligent, and everybody has their own perception and perspective, and then internal politics of the batch is there. Hardly few teams are there which actually sync with each other and collaborate. Their number of teams, you can count it, how many? Hardly two per batch. Am I right or wrong? Three maybe. But it never grows more than four or five. It never comes to the 50% of the batch. Again, if you take the statistics, it comes to hardly 10%, 20% of the batch, which actually makes the proper collaborative teams and really able to do it. But then after that, they are able to mature to the product level, or a good project level is not guaranteed. But our experience is forming teams, actually, teams which perform are those one which does mixed teams. Mixed teams means you should form a team from first year, second year, third year, fourth year combined together. That works better. Why? Because there is a hierarchy of the work also. Though we are not believing in hierarchy, but there is a hierarchy of the work. There is a something work which to be fixed quickly. Any person with a 10th class knowledge can do it. Next level of a work is there which needs a little more knowledge, a mental faculty that isn't further, and so and so. But the moment you have a mixed teams, then you can spread out the work and optimize the work per person. And that works better. That's the reason that open source communities are working better. I hope you understood, right? When you take an open source community, they are mixed teams. They are cross-cultural. They're coming with the mixed domains. They're coming with mixed experience. They don't differentiate based on the knowledge and your year of experience and all. No, no, no. It depends on what your contribution you want to do it. But our college project doesn't work. So this is another interesting input I'm giving example as that moment you build a community, community should be governed by culture. And culture is governed by these factors that you should talk about contribution, collaboration, conventions, and continuity is very important. And continuity, now see, moment you made a mixed team, first year, second year, third year, fourth year combined together. Fourth year, third year people visioned something. Okay, they made an architecture, they designed it. First year, second year are already involved with them from the day one. If they are not getting the input about the architecture, they are getting it, right? Are they designing it? No. But they are part of the process. Moment you will pass out, these people will take on. And that's how actually project's continuity gets solved. And then it matures to the next level. Next level, next level, next level. I just give you another example. FOSS, we are running for the last 15 years. But similar to that, we have a Ragam and Tattva and other one of the largest events happening in NIT Calicut. A similar case with all other colleges also. Okay, they're all cultural fest is there, technical fest is there. In Ragam and Tattva, team makes software for Ragam and Tattva every year from scratch. Almost from scratch. I ask the question, why you people are doing that? They say, okay, we need a live project experience. But why? Why they are doing it? Are not we are wasting the human resources? Are not wasting our time? Are not we are doing the hard work? We are doing the hard work. Really, we are doing the hard work. We slog. We produce such a wonderful piece of code, but then we chuck it out. We dump it. We never evolve to next level. That's another example of Another example I'm telling you, live case example, which we've seen in so many years. When I was in a campus, I proposed like Ragam software over here, or any of the technical, you know, event software example, okay, was made by MCA people earlier. Then I proposed to my team, whichever the name, let's make an open source product. Let's make it with a good coding guidelines. Let's talk about not a full-fledged product at a time. Let's talk about the minimal viable product which works, and then we'll keep on passing to the juniors and then so and so. Nobody agreed. You know why? Reason was, we have to sit for placements. In placement, in your resume, you want to show that, oh, this is the project, I have done it. These are called external factors which are contributing to your community killing, right? And it never worked. It never happened. And the same trend is continuing. And today, actually, if I came in a campus, one of the reasons is, let's break those things. Let's mark the mistakes which we are doing it. Let's talk about the good decision which people does it. Let's talk about the future. I wish to see that from here, the FOSS community from across the campuses in Kerala, they should produce a substantial throughput in terms of open source or free software. So it means it's a structural problem which can be solved very easily if we agree on something. So I'm ready to experiment with you guys over here. I'm ready to experiment with the FOSS community over here in NIT Calicut, because this is my hometown. This is my home campus. Anytime I'm available for just to guide you people, you know, what can be done, what should you do, what you should not do it. Okay? So that we have a far more better visibility coming across the globe. That's why we are lagging behind it. If we compare outside world, people talk about open hardware there. Why not we are talking about here? Raspberry Pi happened over there. Why not Raspberry Pi happened over here? Question is this. Raspberry Pi happened in front of us. Am I right or wrong? It happened in front of us. Hardly 8 or 7, 9 years back, when I was in a campus, at that time in embedded system, there was not a credible, even a single board available in open hardware where you can do the embedded programming. What do you have to buy? You have to buy Xilinx board, their source code, their whole of the tool chain. You have to buy the TI's board and their tool chain and so and so. You didn't have a single one common hardware available where you can do the lot of wonderful experimentation, and that learning you can carry on. The problem with the close thing is what? You will learn their tool chain, and that whole of the things you can't reapply again. And then your learning will get wasted in so many nuances here and there rather than a deeper one. Raspberry Pi happened. Then similarly thing, TI understood it. Okay, this is the way to go. They launched BeagleBone. BeagleBone black, BeagleBone white, and so, then lot many boards came around it. But question is not this. My question is, why we Indians are not able to think about this idea the day one? We are. Now, believe me, I'll just give you example. When I was studying in 2007 over here, we had one team from a mixed other from across the departments, one team was made. That team was led by Shridhar, and that is about the vehicle. Then Johann George was there and all. So some people are from mechanical, some were from computer science, some were from electronics, and they made a car. And the car were driving car, which actually detects your road based on the image processing and so on, 15 years back. We did it. But is that product got carried on? No. If the product would have been carried on, always improvement happens sequentially. Always improvement happens sequentially, iteratively, step by step. You can't carry it in a single day such a complex project. No, it's not possible. And that died. Nobody taken forward. If that would have been taken forward in last 15 years, we would have been driving autonomous vehicle over here and around Kerala. Can you see the difference? So now, I give you a guarantee, there is no issue with aptitude as such. There is no issue with the technical capability and competency. Because you take the population of India and take the percentage of people who are coming in engineering college, that is really, really very minuscule one. Out of 100 crore people, you are representing only few. Only few. Okay? And you take the other world's population, they are coming out of only small set of population. We are already coming from a very hard, different competition. Only thing is, the issue is mindset. Issue is a mindset. Now let's start working on this one now. So I'll just give you another example. Now this ragging part, which I told you that everywhere banner is there. We solved that problem in our time. How we solved it? That's what I'm sharing with you now, guys. Okay, what good decision we did it. I was in second year MCA at that time, and we had this IEEE FOSS community, and very vibrant community I was there at that time. These were the most active community at that time. We went to the A hostel. We talked with the first year directly. We took a permission. It was horrible. And then after that, we gone over there. We talked with them. Okay, what do you would like to have to? Would you like to work with us? We given them an equal status. We given them an equal opportunity. We have never treated them as a junior. We have treated them as a compatriot with us, as a team member with us. We did a small workshop in the hostel about the mechanics, about the automation stuff, about the programming for first years. Then we planned 3 robotics workshops. And the 3 robotics workshops was a stage manner. First one was done. And that first one was, first year and second year are eligible for that. If third year and fourth year want to participate, they are allowed to do that. And the fees was 2,000 rupees at that time, 15 years back. 2,000 was a very large number, right? Am I correct? Now, the moment you do the robotics, you need a special board. Now, Arduino and all things are there. At that time, that was not the case. We have a special board, which was done by some other company. We hired their services, and they came as a husband and wife, and together, they did this. That interesting part is, when we planned the first year one, that first year workshop was, there is no programming involved, board is already programmed. They had to actually link everything, actuators, all those wheels and motions and all, then they make to it a drive as a robot from morning to evening, but everything hands-on, soldering till last stage. Do you know that how much participation? We have over here 3 halls. This is Bhaskara. This is middle size. Arabid is the largest. Then behind this is one more Chanakya. Chanakya was a full. We didn't have a place to sit. Then what happened with that actually? It has created a culture. It has created a culture. The culture where people start talking and fiddling with hands. We talk about open hardware. We talk about open source software. But believe me, unless you work with your hand, nothing will happen. And the tragedy with our academia, mostly people are doing what? Theoretical work. Just passing the exams. You had to work with your hands. And that first year became second year, one of the best wonderful guys we've seen around. Then over here we have that Team Unwired, right? Team Unwired was set up. That is actually the participant of which competition? Baja competition, or Baja. There is Baja automobile competition there. Most of the people knows about it. You can search it. It's a rigorous competition. That lab was set by Prateek Kalyankar when he was in final year. Team Unwired was set by Prateek Kalyankar. He was in when final year. But seed was sown when he was in first year. I hope you got it right. So moment you want to make a thriving community, not only here in your campuses, please talk to first year first rather than to the final year. Why? The trend is this one, across campus. I'm not talking about even over here or your campus, even IITs. First year goes in a shock. Is this what we are doing as engineering? Second year, we realize we are doing engineering. We are in engineering. Third year, actually, we feel like we are doing engineering. Why? Actual core subject starts there. By fourth year, you get placed up to ho gai. Right? That's the trend across. Ego issues are, in IIT's ego issues are, who got placed on first day? NIT's ego issues are, who got the highest salary? In other campus, another is. Only parameters are changing. But is the pattern is changing? No. That's another reason we are not productive as a student community. We are not. Because we are building everything in silos. First year separate, second year separate, third year separate, fourth year separate, and everything is going by a factual, those type of factors which will not pay a good heed in your life at all. I'll give you a guarantee from here when you pass, when you get a job, after earning 3 years right, you will not feel that money is very important. You will not feel it. Only you keep on jumping the job just for a status, okay, from this car to this bigger car and all. And so, but at the large, are you really contributing? That's very important for surviving and making motivated yourself. You want to motivate yourself, you want to be happy, become a contributor. That's very, very important factor. And start working with everybody, first year, second year, third year, fourth year. That's the message for all of you guys. Okay, now comes next. And then automatically culture of innovation will be there. Example is we have Team Envired. From Team Envired, now there are four more clubs came, I came to know that. Aero Molding Club is there and so and so. So this is automatic. It will automatically happen. Okay, so start building community first. Now comes to the next one. I'll give you the small history. So this is the motivation behind this talk. Why I'm giving this talk, why this community is actually the target audience for this one, because student is the most important aspect in any nation. Because this is the largest chunk of intellectual existing. Okay. Is faculty the largest chunk? No. We have 300 faculty in NIT Calicut. Your campus may have 200, 400, but how many students are there? 5,000 over here. In your campus is some more and all. This is the largest intellectual chunk existing in any nation. If this doesn't work, nation will not work. You take it. If this doesn't work, nation will not work. Now let's make student work. Okay? So that's the idea why I'm talking with you guys now. Okay, now I'll explain you FOSSMeet past. Very quick history. It started in 2005 at NITC. Okay, over here. And this was a small poster. I'm sorry, I'm not able to get a bigger JPEG image or something, because online now those things are got lost somehow. It started by Praveen and Dilip. Both were from, I think, electrical branch. That's what my understanding says. Praveen still is active. Dilip is active in startups. And Dr. KP Mohandas, he was a counselor for IEEE. And then CSI, I think Rajagopalan sir was also involved. I think so. Okay, but I'm not sure. So this is actually resolution was very poor, so you can't see it. Now this was started at that time, and we are sitting in our 15th edition. So this was called as at the time Gluck FOSSMeet, GNU Linux user group Calicut. But believe me, is there is anything a user group was there? Only few people get together, okay, are interested in something FOSS and let's start doing it. Okay? And then came, okay, here in a, they're sitting in a mini canteen, they started discussing, because most of the idea discussed on napkins, right? And they said, let's do it. Then they went to Dr. KP Mohandas, sir, we want to do something related to the FOSS. Yes, what is that? Okay, this is there. Not a problem, we'll support you. They came with the idea, they identified the speakers and all, IEEE CSA supported it, things started happening. Fine. So that's the, so it means to say, when you want to do something, initiative is very important. You take the initiative, world will garner by you. Believe me, world will not wait for you. World will follow you. You start thinking and take initiative, world will follow you. Nobody says no to a good idea. That's what my experience is. Who are the speakers? Atul Chitnis, I think most of the people knows this guy. He's no more now. He was a profound FOSS evangelist, as well as, you know, a good, I will say, good corporate guy also. Savroop C.S., Shankar Balan, Pradeep Kishore Goda. If you search online a byte of Python, how many of you know the Python language? Raise your hands. Okay. If you search online a byte of Python, this is the guy who written it. And he given the Python workshop at that time 15 years back. At that time, we were not knowing about the Python at all. Nobody was knowing it. If at that time, we took in a hand count, zero. But now, see, this is another interesting prevalence now. See, we have reached to that level that now most of the people know this stuff. Okay, Savroop CH and then other two guys was there. Now schedule, 9 talks, 2 workshop, March 18, 2016. Then 2006 happens, next year. We expanded. Before that, it was just a flyer. There was no vision, mission. There was no depth as such. Okay, there was nothing to talk about the freedom as such. Though Atul Chitnis had talked about a little bit something about that, but his talk, I don't know, I forgot what the topic was. But then after that, we started talking about think freedom. That's the first chance we started thinking about freedom. What is freedom? What is the meaning of freedom? And when we made a think freedom, we were very clear about it when we make posters. When we made a think freedom, we embossed at the back also, right? It's called marketing strategy. Your brain learns subconsciously more rather than consciously. You go around. Why in all the ads kids are there? Your kid affect your subconscious mind rather than conscious mind. That's why you end up buying it. So we were very clear about it. We were very clear about it the second year itself what we are going to do it. We were clear about it, what we are going to do it. That's about the think freedom. And then we laid out a lot of areas. Just let me read for you guys. Inside Edge. .gnu, embedded code, FOSS Foundry, okay? Then there are a lot of talks about that, then making things work. Title was very clear. What are the talks, what is the theme of that? If talks are related just only hands-on and making things work, that's a making things work. If something is related to the inside, internals, frameworks, that is really inside one. When the .gnu was there, this was given by a guy, Gopal V. He was the person who was contributing in that project. That became a mono project, then mono touch, now it's called Xamarin and so history is there. And he actually talked about internals. How internally get button get created, and moment you click on handler, how handler get called internally. Interesting stuff, okay, which we are interested in. Then one part was philosophy, when we talk about, okay, fine, intellectual, creative common was a very new thing at that time for everybody. We made sure that topic is there, okay. Then hands-on, and then finale, some game programming, something was there. These are all topics, okay, network security. This was given by Kalyan. Now, these hands-on, actually, the live CD one was done by student itself. We had a very sure that student projects should be presented over here, which have done a commendable effort. We want to give them visibility. We want to give them applauding hands. Awesome, my dear, you've done a good work. Please go back and further work, and then come back next year also. We are happy to receive it. But now, in FOSSMeet, we don't have that stuff. We should do it. We should do it. Now comes to the next one. This logo on the left side was designed by Nimish Moon, this logo. And we were clear at that time itself, second year itself, and still is there. I'm happy about it. We have a continuity. We have not lost our brand name. That still is promoting, and this was designed by Nimish Moon. And he asked, what is this after all, freedom and all? When it's about caring and... You remember that two words we used? Right? Bringing a culture of caring. Then he sat and he designed it. And still we don't know why the hole is there. Seriously. Because somebody asked me, Mania, that's a designer choice. He thought something and he designed it. Okay? Now, but the theme is clear. Now comes to the participation organization. I will explain you, these are not just logos over there. I'll explain you which way we used to work. First edition 2005 was done by IEEE in association with CSA. Initiative taken by Pradeep and Dilip. Next year onwards, I was leading IEEE at that time. I was the chairperson. And we said, let's expand it. How to expand? Not in number of talks. Let's expand by including more communities around it. What are the more communities are there? Let's include other clubs also. CSA, Gluck, this logo I designed it. There was no logo for Gluck. Okay? And all these are pencil drawn. Took a photograph, done it and so. Make sense? No, not photograph, scanning. That's why these are looking like this. CSA, now we have a better logo. Awesome, hands off to that guy who done it. At that time, we don't have a CSA. Computer Science Engineering Association was not a very active association, a department level club. It was not very active at all. For namesake, people are there. In our colleges, there are a lot many clubs are there. In your college also, a lot of clubs are there, which are lying in dormant state. Dormant state means you have office bearers, but nothing is happening. And that was the case at that time. And but we said, okay, fine. We were very clear about it. Computer science department should become integral part of FOSS from the day one. How to do that? Student community. That's a CSEA. That's it. Officially we gone and done it. This debate came in front of us at that time when we were sitting in a meeting. Hey, Amarjit, this is IEEE event. It should be IEEE, by IEEE, for IEEE and all. But no. This is about freedom. This is about the FOSS. If you have not understood the freedom, then you have not really understood it. It is about building community. It's not creating the boundaries and wall. It's actually dismantling the walls and boundaries. And then we started including a lot of communities around it. Then space came. Now we have IT Kerala mission, and after that we have an IRC force, NRC force. But at that time, space was a community which was actually doing a lot of stuff at a Kerala level. We included them. An important point was inclusion, not exclusion at all. We include. Exclusion is zero. The sponsor were TCS, they've given us a very handsome money. An important point is when we take sponsor, we invite them over here, not as a sponsor talk, we invite as an industry representative. We used to have in DIAS five stakeholders. I'll show you what the five stakeholders we talk about. Industry should be there, government should be there, okay? Alumni should be there, so our administration should be there, director used to represent that administration, faculty should be there, and student community should be there. But now how many faculties are representing over here? It means something, we lost it. We have to solve that problem again. Okay? Make sure these stakeholders play part in that. It's not a student project. No, no. FOSSMeet is not that. It's a meetup where like-minded people come from a different walks of life, sit together and talk and discuss and share the ideas and just work till 11 o'clock in the night and solve some problems and go back home. That's what the culture. It's not a conference. Right now we have made it purely in a conference mode. Okay? That we have to again fix it. We have to fix it. We'll fix it. Now speakers which came, few of the names are there. Arunam, he's still active in FOSS community. Okay? And Gopal, he was really awesome guy. One of the brightest guy I have seen in my life. Then he worked in Yahoo. We was in touch. And you know, see, it's not about, you know, attending the conference. Over here you come, you build relationships. And that relationship exists with you ever, forever in your life. And most of the speakers are still my friends. A wonderful friend. If somewhere, do you think in a life you don't have a dilemma ever again that what should I do, what should I don't do? You have every day. It's not over here, which language should I study? What framework I should learn? What and all these are questions are there, no? All the student-oriented questions. After this also is there. Every 3 year you will come across a very big question in your plate. What is the next transition I should do? After 10 years of career, again you will come across a question. Now which level I will find ended up? And believe me, you can't break that challenge. Right now you have a mentors over here, faculties and all. You are paying for it. After this, nobody will, you are not going to pay for that. And believe me, if you don't have a circle around you, nobody will be there to help you evolve to next level. Make sense, right? So it's a community. It's not a conference. It's not a talk which you should come and attend and go. No, it's a meetup where you just open up, build up a relationship, talk with the people, try to understand what they are doing, try to sit with them. What, okay, let me pick up something out of it. And believe me, these are one of the wonderful people in a life you will come across which has done something interesting and they'll keep on contributing life forever. Forever, I'm saying. Depends on you, your attitude. So Kalyan Verma, he evolved to next level. He became he was a photographer. Came from College of Engineering, Trivandrum, I think so. See, interesting story about this guy. He was a FOSS contributor, security guy. He was working in Yahoo. He was a part of team. The team name itself was Paranoid. And then he loves wild photography. You can search it, Kalyan Verma, wild photography. You'll get a link of that. Lot of photographs, he published it, and all photographs he made free, available to anybody. That somebody from the Discovery or Nat Geo has seen his photograph, because he ended up taking a photograph of one frog which was an endangered species which never seen it, and they say this guy has something interesting. They hired him. Okay, so it means to say, if you think your career is linear, wrong. Career is always graph. It's not a linear. If you think, okay, you have done BTech, computer science, you will be computer science forever. No, it's not. Okay? So you will evolve as the time passes. You will evolve to a better human being all the time. And this question is always a challenging question for a human to survive, exist, and evolve to the next level. And one of the important point is, you would never evolve individually. Community evolves you. It never happens. Nobody become a great in silo. Nobody. Take about anybody. You talk about even a single example to me that who became a great in silo. Newton said, I am happy I am seeing on the shoulders of great giants. That's true. You can't create those type of stuff in a single day. No, it doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. So build a community around it. Then Parveed Leap, Sharath Lakshman. This was another guy, young guy, who came and experimented with creating live CDs and all. And we invited him, hey, come over here, give a demo over here. We are happy to see you. Okay, young guy, I think he was in second year at that time. Modern Engineering College. He came, we invited him, hey, my dear, you come. Okay, and we given him a space, you talk over here what you did it. Okay, so now another Sharash, another wonderful guy, and so, Anjan. This is, see, we were very clear at that time about open hardware. We had a full-fledged talks related to the embedded Linux, embedded systems earlier, in the second session itself. Second of our FOSS meet, but when it became third meet in 2007, this hall, this Bhaskara hall, full day from morning to evening, everything related to the embedded internals and so. That was the evolution. But tragedy, what happened? After that, those things got stopped. If that would have been stopped, I give you a guarantee, we would have created open hardware. We would have created open hardware rather than picking Raspberry from outside. It's a fact. Because this guy is working in EPLF. What is the best university in Switzerland? He's there. He did PhD over there. And his PhD, the guy, person who took him a PhD, based on what? What the hell he did it with embedded system. He was out of the box. He had not relied on his academic scores at all. Academic scores matter to a certain extent, but believe me, that can be challenged. Where work, nobody can challenge it. In this world, only one thing is indisputable, that is your work. Nobody can dispute. They can deny you. They can delay your work. They can delay your recognition, but they can't dispute it. Make sense, right? So this is what the charm of when you come to the FOSS community, okay? Over here, people love to work. People go internals. People love to play with the hands and all, and so and so. And this is the guy who framed his answer sheet with the zero marks and still kept in his home. Okay? That's the guy I'm talking about. Now we have then Kushal Das. Can you see BO of his there? Bird of Feather. We have this type of sessions over here. Now it doesn't happen. Bird of Feather sessions. Bird of Feather sessions are what? Idea sessions, basically. Very quick. Okay, all of you. Some of the people, okay, we'll put a whiteboard outside. We'll stick over their topics. Okay, I'm interested in this topic, which is not part of the regular talks. Okay, I have done something interesting. I want to show you guys. We'll put it over here. Whoever is interested, they will get together and start discussing. That's it. We used to sit till 11 o'clock over in the stairs. This stairs till 11 o'clock. Doing something interesting. Then we'll continue for dinner. Next day also we are coming. So this is actually the meetup. I hope you got it, right? It's a far more unstructured format rather than the college. If we end up running the same way, then there is no difference between what college runs and what we are running it. College is again structured, right? And innovation happens because of unstructured thing, not because of structured things. Okay. So now comes to next. That 2007. We made sure it is all about freedom, sharing. It is embossed, light color at the back. Why? Because we want that your subconscious mind should learn that what is freedom. What is freedom? And then a lot of other talks was there and all. It happened in March 2007. And this time, within a 3 years, this became a mammoth FOSSMeet. Approximately 60 speakers was there. 100 talks, this ABC, Aryabhatta, Bhaskara, Chanakya, all those full all the days. Then we have three labs, more than four departments was involved, computer science department, electrical department, mechanical department also involved. We created a workshop for them, Octave and all. We are making sure every time we do the FOSSMeet, there are a few more communities get added. We will not delete anything, we'll add. Okay, that was the charm. That was what we are doing at that time. And it exploded to a such a huge level. We even targeted that. Why not we have a chief minister coming over here? Seriously. When we're discussing in a meeting, and this idea came, let's invite chief minister. Most of the people are laughing here. Pagal hai, chief minister invite karenge? Now we have discussion that we should invite director. Director should be here. Seriously. We were inviting chief minister, and he agreed on. But he was not able to come because of some budget session and all. Okay, the idea was simply that think big. Then do it. It's not about the chief minister, we are going to ask him something over here, privilege or favor over here. No, we want to pass the freedom of idea to him also. An interesting part is, Kerala is the only state where the FOSS community became such a wonderful and vibrant, and it has become into the government structure also. There are a lot of government schools now are dealing with the FOSS. It doesn't happen in Punjab. And I wish that some people come from here to my Punjab and do it something interesting over there. I hope you got it. Over a government structure is very vibrant. If you talk about something sensible at that level, even as a student, they will listen to you. If you think you can't change the nation, you can. It's your aspiration, what level you want to touch it. Okay, now comes to the next one. So speakers, I'm just listing into the topic, FOSS in professional life. Atul Chetan, wonderful talk. Still I remember the talk. Almost all talks still I remember. Unconference, how to talk about unstructured conferences. Kirba Shankar, an interesting blogger. Then we have a few more things, job component, Baiju. Then day two, localization, Praveen. Praveen, most of the people over here know is already. Okay. Anjan again came, embedded system. Then open source CMS and all. And there are a lot of talks was there. And whenever we had a talk, I'll just give you example that what generally how we used to actually structure the talks. Now, right now, what I see, major of the talks are student talks. And most of the talks are actually consumer perspective that how to consume an API, how to call a function, how to create using this stuff. Most of the talks are that way. Rarely a talk is there which will deal to internal. Kasim talk is going to come tomorrow. He'll talk about internals of Android. And over here, we used to have 50% talks which are internals. How Python works internally, how Linux works internally, how memory works internally, and so and so. I'll give you one example. What happened, interesting stuff with this. There are these are all so many talks. We did it over here. And Billy, can you imagine? These talks are only one track. I am able to get only that much data, which is published online. It's only one track. We had three track running parallelly. And one track was running in Chanakya Hall. That track was purely Linux kernel and internals. And we were scheduling the talks. At that time, we had a debate in a team over here. Hey, Amarjit, why we are putting these many internal talks and deeper talks? A student will be there who can grasp and understand. If where the professionals are coming, who have a 5 to 10 years of experience of dealing with those stuff, is they will be able to carry on. The hall will be empty. Money, I don't care. Let hall will be empty. Even a single person is there, that's perfectly fine for us. Because we are not looking for the dogs. We are looking for one single line of star world. We are very clear about it. A debate came in front of our faculty. Third time we had a faculty advisor, Vinod Pathari, sir. And he also said, Amarjit, yaar, hall will be empty. Then, you know, it will be very embarrassing for speakers and all of us if nobody is there and all. And then we have to run to the hostel to bring the people. Mane, no, we'll not go and run a hostel. Let hall will be empty. We'll inform speaker. That's it. You have one audience, deal with him personally. Then they sat with him personally, work over there. Okay, so a culture is very simple. We don't want to run a school college. We don't want to run that structure setup. We have to evolve this setup. Rather, we want to change that setup. Okay, so FOSSMeet is not about just open source software. It's about freedom. Let's break that structure. Let's do it. We have a power to do it. And we are talking about it simply. And it happened. Now see, by surprise, that was one of the most populated hall, Chanakya. From morning to evening, people attended the Linux kernel talks. Now, interesting story I'll tell you behind it. Suparna Bhattacharya, you people don't know. There's Suparna Bhattacharya, anybody heard about the name? Suparna Bhattacharya? Okay. She is the lady, she is the girl who actually contributed in EXT4 file system. EXT4, all of you know, right? EXT3, EXT4, right? She is the girl, she used to work in IBM. IBM has a lot of different kind of division. One is called India Software Lab. She was part of India Software Lab. India Software Lab has a one center which is called Dynamics Technology Center. She used to work over there. I'm not sure she is still there or not, but she used to work there. And she contributed in EXT4 file systems design. You can read his paper. His paper is there. I met her when we went to FOSS.in, second edition when we had over here. After that, we went to FOSS. I met over here. And I was really very impressed with her talk. Wonderful. Wonderful girl to interact. Wonderful lady and very knowledgeable and all. We built up a relationship. We came. Then we were doing 2007 edition. We approached IBM for sponsorship through Suparna. IBM said, IBM has a lot of process. You know, it takes a lot of time to actually get the approval. They take approximately sometime 1 month too, because mail keep on going and so on. I used to get a huge number of mails. Then reply came from there, Amarjit, we can't give you sponsorship. We'll send you 9 speakers. 9 speaker IBM sent it from Linux Technology Center, not their marketing guy. We are very clear. We are very upfront when we used to talk with companies there as a student. Hey, please don't send us a marketing guy. We are not interested in that stuff. Don't send your product guy, we'll teach your product. No, we are interested who knows, who is the engineer, who is the scientist, who is the developer over there. Send him, practitioner. They sent it. 9 people. Chanakya, they take care of. That hall was full of that only. Did I paid for them? No, IBM took care of it. Travel expenses and all. And see, one of the guy came from a Linux debugging team. He was the head of Linux debugging team. And he ended up doing a workshop from morning to evening for Linux debugging. Full morning to evening. Now can you imagine what is the impact it will have? Your MTech and PhD project will go to next level. Most of the time we waste time where? Fiddling with the things. Fiddling with the things because learning curve is steep. And that's exactly what happened. Now I'll tell you in that Linux track, there was one PhD guy and then the 2 MTech guys also given the talk. First time ever we introduced. That all, let's come, whoever done something interesting come, and they contribute from our campus only. So I'm just giving the idea what we have thought about and what we made it. Okay, and the, as the time passes, that idea fiddled. That's why I'm coming again. And just to enlighten you which way we was, let's make it big again. Let's think about a bigger idea. It's not about the number of people. It's not about the number of speakers. It's not about the number of talks. It's about inclusion and participation. We never said no to anybody. Even a single speaker, we said no. Never said no. They said, oh, we want to come to your FOSSMeet. We want to speak. Hey, come, buddy. What is the topic you want to give? Come. Students said, okay, fine. Let's have some time. If there is not a time in the schedule, then let's have a lightning talks, 5-minute talk. What are the ideas you want to present in whatever break is there? Come, enlighten your people. What are the things you want to think about it? Bob sessions, bird of feather sessions, which are totally unstructured informal sessions, which are going on parallelly. I hope you got it, right? So when next time you come for a FOSSMeet over here, I'm telling to all of you guys, please pass message to your juniors and next. Over here you come with open brain. Come as a contributor, not as a just information consumer. We are not interested in consumers. I'm telling you sincerely. I'm blunt about it. We are not interested in consumer and consumerism. We are interested in contribution and collaboration. If you're ready to contribute, you're ready to collaborate, most welcome in NITC. Most welcome. We'll welcome you with open hearts. Now, come example. See, when we had over here embedded track was going on, when VLSE CAD tool talk was there. VLSE CAD tool talk was there. We're using open source. Okay? Other guy which I told you, Anjan took an embedded system, then this guy took it something else. And we have full-fledged track was running over here. Then Pramod C came afterwards also. Some of the people might be knowing it. And he's very, very active guy still. Okay? Then we have a panel discussion, other stuff, and so on and so. I'm just giving, these are all public data I'll share with you guys. I want that, you should enjoy it. We had a lunch. Lunch and dinner was really awesome. We used to make sure that everybody is pampered well in a food wise also. Okay? We had a FOSS project demos also, which is no more now. Okay? We should do it. Now our FOSS community in NIT Calicut also evolved to this level. We should adopt some of the projects. Adopt. Seriously, I'm telling you, we should adopt it, take ownership, and talk about their architecture internals and all, and then keep on passing year to year to the next generation so that people learn deeper part. Makes sense, right? And that's how you will make money. That's how even I make money. Now, so even this simple, smaller product, we given a space at that time. Hey, please come and you did something interesting, your own, come. Present it over here. We'll give you 10-minute slot. Perfectly fine for us. Okay? Then in addition to this, we have a community meetups also, which is not happening nowadays over here. Community, lot of other community we used to invite, and they used to come over here and have a meeting. Santata Malayalam Computing meeting over here used to happen, and so and so. So it means it was totally community driven. I hope you got it, right? When we used to finalize the speakers, I'll tell you how we used to finalize speakers. Now we have a funnel and all, but a lot of things are bad over there. That I will discuss it. We used to identify the speaker, one of the wonderful speakers around, across India and outside. We used to go to a lot of other conferences, FOSS did and all. When we identify some speakers, we talk to them. Can you propose something with you, your inner circle, who is really awesome? This is the thing we are looking for. And really, that's how they used to come. They used to come as a team, as a friends. And the moment you come as a friends and teams, you enjoy over here. You got it, right? I'll share you Flickr photographs of that time. People have played the basketball. People done a holi also over here, in addition to the lot of other stuff. Okay, I hope you got it right. So it's not a monologue. It's a community where you interact and play with each other and share the idea and evolve. Now comes next. Now what is the vision? We were very clear about it. Promoting and adopting freedom and openness. From openness, not only term came, at the time we had just freedom. That's why in all posters everywhere you think freedom. And now I'm happy that now current poster has still kept the think free. Only DOM has gone. And they have added one more line, code better, awesome stuff. That's called evolution. Okay? We have not gone away from what we supposed to do it. Okay? But few things, I think we had to fix it. Mission, we never fixed at that time. But we had a clear-cut objective. Very clear-cut objective at that time defined. Some of the objectives I'm telling you, promotion of FOSS and FOSS adoption, interdisciplinary engineering. That was a clear-cut objective for us. And FOSS gives you opportunity for that. That's why we are involving multiple departments, multiple associations, a student from a different background, alumni, or speakers from a lot many different backgrounds, such that we have an interdisciplinary nature coming in over here in our academics. Innovation happens because of diversity. Breakthrough innovations are hardly not even 1%. Breakthrough innovation like what Einstein did it or somebody else, right? But most of the majority of innovations happen because of diversity. Diverse people come with a diverse mindset. They talk about something, they end up seeing in a different perspective and create it. Okay? Makes sense, right? So it's always incremental. And that's, we are very clear about it. Otherwise, interdisciplinary is a very sexy word. It's beaten around everywhere. Most of the campuses talk about it. Most of academia talk about it. But they never broken this problem. They never solved this problem. We solved it as a community over here. In our NIT Calicut, though, there are possible interdisciplinary that you can take a course from across the department and all, that is possible. Global elective, but in university system, that's not possible. Okay? But to how much level? Only few. But what we are talking about interdisciplinary, far more deeper stuff. An idea is, charm is, everything is going by whom? Student community. Only faculty was their advisor. Everything was taught and done by students. Okay? Now comes to the next one. Industry institute engagement, interaction. This is again a very heavy thing which everybody want to solve it as a problem, but nobody is able to solve. Except IIT Chennai and so they have a R&D park and all. We are not able to solve this problem. Few of the campuses has a very active alumni. College of Engineering Trivandrum, Guindy College, IIT Madras, they have a very active alumni. But NIT Calicut, I'm telling you frankly, we struggle. We don't have a very vibrant, active alumni is there, vibrant alumni. I hope you got it. Now, it's again a problem is what? Culture problem. It's a community problem, culture problem. And the culture has to be solved. Now, we are dealing with that stuff. We are trying to figure it out how to do it. But if you ask me, we are ahead of time, 15 years back itself, we are solving that problem. Because over here, how many people are sitting from industry? Approximately 100 people. Now, how many are there? Raise your hands. How many are coming from industry? Only one. This problem, we have to solve it next time. Okay? Please, young guys, note it. We have to solve it. I'll tell you how to solve it. We'll solve it. Okay? There are ways to do it. Last time I came, we had a discussion. Amarjit, can you pull out some industry people? Believe me, they will not come. No. Unless something is there for them also. Talk level has to evolve. You got it, right? Discussion level has to evolve. If you come as a consumer, nobody's interested. Nobody's interested in coming. If you come as a contributor and you take some ownership, yes, I want to do something interesting, let's talk about something deeper and all, then people will, okay, there are some people are there who are interested in this stuff, then I'm ready to spend time for them. Makes sense, right? Otherwise, nobody is interested in wasting time. So, now, we are very clear about FOSS engagement, community engagement and contribution, student community empowerment, administration activation. We used to involve admission, we used to involve director also. Okay? We invite government as a stakeholder. This is one of the important stakeholders we used to invite over here. Somebody should come for sure, either secretary or somebody. Okay? Then society development and engagement, all this was there. Okay? So this is, I'm talking about just third edition. Atul Chitnis was one of the person actually who came as a speaker and who enlightened us. And when he was handling an event over there in Bangalore, which was FOSS.in, that was the largest event at that time in all over India. And he said, I have never seen any meetup growing like this the way NIT Calicut has grown just in 3 years. Okay, so it means student community has a lot of power. You are the biggest intellectual chunk in nation. Moment you move, nation will move. Once again, I'm saying, moment you will move, nation will move. You need not to search for internship, you need not to search for the job. People will come. Hey, interesting stuff, you did it. Let's come and I'll take you. I'm telling you, guarantee. This is how it's a fact, it's a truth. And now we face people, you know, we want internship, we want this. FOSS community is such a vibrant, internship is available anywhere, all the time. You pick any project, what are the area you're interested in, however small may be. You want interested in only fixing documentation, fix documentation. That doesn't need any intellectual facility, which you talk about logical ability and all. But what you're showing, you have the ability to take and do contribution and ownership, your name will go away. outside. And then perfectly fine. Nowadays, people hire by seeing your GitHub profile rather than something else. Things have changed, my dear. It's not that, you know, placements are falling across campuses. It's across. I'm telling you, world has changed around it. I just give you example. Flipkart signed with Coursera that whoever take their Android courses, and whoever the best, will hire it. Make sense, right? Fine. So things are changing in a big way. 20% of the employee of a Google and similar companies has no degree at all. Has no degree at all. 20%. Big chunk. Tomorrow, this is how it is going to be. And now you people are worried about certificate and all. I've seen over here certificates are promised. For us also, people asked, can you give us a certificate? We said, no. We'll not give certificate. You contribute in code, that's your certificate. Simple. That's how it is. And next year onwards, I recommend to my young people, please discourage certificates, okay? That doesn't serve any purpose. It doesn't serve any purpose. I'm telling you frankly. That's just a piece of paper. It doesn't have any credibility in the market. Nobody sees that. It's a wrong perception you people have built it. Okay? That's the challenge with our student community in India, that everything is going by marks, CGPA, and this small thing certificate. You have a very instant gratification. These are called instant gratification. A moment you have instant, see, if I give you a question, and then you're troubled, and then you keep on asking, tell me the answer also. If I tell you answer, instant gratification. You will not go back and dig it. Make sense, right? So kill these instant gratifications. Make sure people slog. Next time we want that people should do the project and come over here. We'll happy to support it. I'll give you an example. I had an open source project over there. It's called NVDA, non-visual desktop access over here. I can show you. That was a project that was done by blind people, two Australians. Two blind people written the code, which is called NVDA, non-visual desktop access, such that they can work on a computer machine. Okay? All the proprietary solution was there, which was not working to their need. They end up writing from scratch their own on Windows platform. And that's now largest and one of the best projects. You know that? And that project came to us, and we wanted to support that with 1 crore funding, 1 CR. We are not able to find a single guy who can contribute from India. You think work is not there? It's there. You think opportunities are not there? It's there. But tragedy is nobody is ready to take it up. Then I found 4 interns and I asked them to do it. For 2 months they work, and then all the excuses, this excuse, that excuse, this. This thing doesn't work, my dear. And these are the blind people, those who coded it. Because they felt I should be able to use it, and they made it open source for whole of the world. And you people are being such a capable, are not taking responsibility to contribute anything at all. I think it should be fixed. We'll fix it now, okay? I want this time FOSS community should become active and bigger. So 5 stakeholders, I have told you what we are talking about. So we think big, really big, okay? Start doing that. We involve faculty and department, I told you already history. So every year we keep on expanding it further. CSD, then ECD, then electrical department, then mechanical. Then I told you about Suparna Bhattacharya already, example. Similar to the IBM team, there is a team came from Wipro also. Team came from TCS also. Okay, and we are very upfront. Hey, please don't send a people, those who are manager, no. Send a people, those who really know the stuff. They were really very shocked. How come these guys can talk? Because nobody, you say, it's okay, you give the money perfectly fine, but it doesn't mean that you own us. No, you send a person who can contribute in the community. And believe me, it worked. It worked. You should be upfront, straightforward. It works. Now comes next. Now, I am supposed to talk about all this stuff, FOSS and community and career and society and government and industry, but few things I am explaining it with here and there and all. But major focus of the talk I will concentrate on community and framework. Okay, community is driven by culture, which I explained you. Culture is driven by these things, which also we understood as such, what the meaning of it. Now, nowadays, this is another interesting aspect is going on. Nowadays, people are actually creating a general theory around what is actually freedom and open communities are. Okay? And one of the example of this is P2P Foundation has done very interesting documentation. Very interesting. It's wonderful to read. It's wonderful. That thing will happen in the future, but those glimpses are happening here and there. Free and open source software is one example. Open hardware is happening. But before that, if even society was open. I'll repeat 2 lines which I shared. I shared one story in 2007's opening ceremony. One poet has written a wonderful poem. And he published it. People learnt it. They start singing it. They were using it. And then this poet went to those people. Like, you can't sing this poem. It's my creation. The person replied, this poem and me are now one. You can't differentiate it. I am poem or I am I. That's how the force is. That's how the community is. You can't differentiate. Make sense, right? So now, anything which is created for commons, by commons, used by commons and shared resources, believe me, that's how the commons are. And commons are everywhere. If you think it happened with only FOSS, no, before that it was there. Music, how music was created in India? It was this way only, right? Traditionally from so many years, it is always a free. You just go to the guru and sit it and learn it and keep on passing generation to generation. It was there always. Your house got constructed, carpenter came, you never asked that you bought a table from him and brought it home and you cut the one leg out of the table and the carpenter will never come behind you at home that, oh, you bought a table from me, you have a right on it, you can't cut a table, you are supposed to use this way only. Is it happened that way? No. All culture, all work, everything was this way only earlier. Only thing mess happened in the software. That's why this free movement become important. Okay, Stallman when started promoting it, but this freedom was always there. Even our freedom struggle is one example, biggest living example. Now we have something called P2P, a far more better name. Better name, P2P is nothing, person to person. Graph, few people like together, that's it. But interesting part is, what I liked about this one is, nothing new is there. What is interesting is, they are formalizing it. They are formalizing a framework around it, a framework, a common framework which governs all commons in different domains, different backgrounds. It might be in agriculture, it might be in carpentry, it might be in hardware, it might be in software, it might be in academics. Academics is another example of commons. From beginning it's existing. Okay, and so. Now they are bringing a framework around it. Now what I did, I noted down a few of the points, everything from there only, and I'll just share you a few of the ideas. So, example is common transition. Now read this definition. They have written a very interesting definition. Read it. Okay, so this is reading assignment for all of you guys. We'll open up for question. What I'll do, I'll go end of the slide. Last slide. Okay, all this content is there. See, my presentations are HTML. Okay, just notes. Students love notes, right? I hate PPTs. Seriously, that's one of the horrible stuff. Because a lot of information goes away. These are the notes I'll share with you. Go and read it. You want to go further deeper, go to P2P. Foundation and some other links and all, and keep on reading it. You will evolve as a human being. So these are the notes I'll share you. Please make sure you go through this one, okay? Now let me just, before opening for questions, I'll explain you a few of the ideas which I'd like to add to you guys. A very interesting diagram. All the diagrams are made by them. I have not done anything. I just copy pasted and made proper bullets. Okay, which all students love to do. This is interesting, which I like it. Local and global. Think global, act local. What we are doing it? 5 stakeholders, right? Bigger thing. Think global, act local. Solve over here problems, but think bigger. Now far more a sexy English word is there. Think global, act local. Okay, so this is what I liked over here, which I'm saying. Now, so let me just go to the ideas which for students is important, which I end up writing it for you guys. It's not from there, it's which I end up writing it. Now, let's take one example of this one. Is it readable? Application. I want to learn software coding design. Why should? Design thinking. I should know what is the meaning of design. Design means set of choices. Whose choice is better and wrong, you can tell it. In academics, you only learn time-space complexity, which is a very strict one. But in actual reality, software is a culture. You don't write a software, you write a culture. It's your reflection. The moment you write any code, it's your reflection. You write your perspective. I believe if every underwriting their own perspective, that's how code become messy. Most of the people are not able to solve the large problems, right? The code becomes messy because everybody write their perspective. But perspective should, if gone by a culture, culture conventions and all, then code becomes awesome. That becomes a thriving system, a software. Okay. Now, one example is design thinking in FOSS. Now, most of the students doesn't know how to handle big code base. Am I right? That's where the challenging is. To becoming from a student project to a professional project, this is the biggest hurdle, how to handle a big code base. Now, why I want to handle it? Because I want to talk about openness, I want to explore the frameworks and all. I'll give you some simple example, how to get started with large project. All of you know Python, right? Majority of you people know Python, right? Right? In Python, moment you deal with int 2, large integer number, what happens? It's a question now. We have interaction section, okay? You are not going to listen, you have to answer it now. Okay. If I add in C language two int numbers, can you add any two int numbers and you'll get the, suppose if I add 32,000 plus 32,000, you'll get 64,000? You might get it, you might not, right? If you have 32,000 plus 32,000, you will get 64,000. Pardon? Compiler dependent. Oh, is it? That's an interesting question. Let's now appreciate this stuff now. If you add 32,000 plus 32,000, you will get 64,000 or not? If yes, how many are in favor of yes? No. Just simplest question. Okay, how many are in favor of no? Okay, so there are a lot many. Now let's figure it out, what's the reason behind it? Okay, how many are people saying it's a compiler dependent? Okay. How many people say it's a OS dependent? Okay. How many people say it's a hardware dependent? Okay. Got it, right? Now I want to explain you this stuff. See, if I give it this is the exercise generally. This is the first question I give to even a professional or any student. If you write a sum function, which takes how many out of you have written this function? How many out of you have written this code? All of you, right? If anybody says that they have not written it, they are lying. All of you have written it, right? Okay, fine. How many of you agree this code is good code? Is it a good code? Okay, how many of you have written in exam and your teacher corrected it? All of you? Similar? Okay, let me write one more. Let me write one more. Factorial, right? Factorial, famous. What do you do? Then you do something over here logic wise, then you do what? I'm not writing logic over here, you return fact, right? If this is a perfect code, it'll going to calculate factorial of any n. I give this as assignment. Can you write a factorial for any n? Any n? It can be 100 digit long. Do it. You will realize actual engineering. And how many teachers you correct this code? You write something over here, right? Either for loop or recursive code. Then you return. This is the difference between academics and professionalism. Make sense, right? When you come in a FOSS community, you will learn this stuff. Now I'll give you a simple assignment. In Python, you now let's create a last, let's add end with 7. Can you store this large number in C? Vanilla C, no? Without library, you can't do it, right? Can I do, let's have 1. Answer is right or not? It is, right? Well, L is long, forget it, what is that? But you tell me the number whatever came is right or not. Last it is 7, now 8 is coming, right? You want to count the digit, you can count it. Okay? But actually what Python is doing, is knows how to store the large number. Tomorrow I have a Kotlin workshop. Come over there, I'll explain the design philosophy. Timing now, we are short of time. I don't want to keep on hanging you people. If you are open, then I am continuing. I have no problem. Okay? If you people are open, then I can continue. Now, the question is how to deal with the large numbers. Your academics is most, see, in NIT Calicut, we test that. My faculty can detect it. But most of the local colleges, nobody cares about it. In exam also, this question comes, same factorial. Factorial by recursion. Give a one example of recursion. Factorial is one of the worst example to give a recursion example. You know that? We never solve factorial by recursion. Recursion has a cost, right? This is what the problem with academics. I hope you got it. You will not get actual picture. You will not get actual picture. You want to get actual picture, now I'll tell you, this is what you do. Now what is there? Python is there. Is internet is working? No, okay. Now Python has, this Python's lower implementation is C Python. C, capital C Python, okay? Which is written purely in C. Now, assignment is this one for you guys. Python int, this is Python int. How Python int get converted into C int? Note on this question. Assignment. One reading assignment already given it, right? This is the next one. How Python int get converted into C int? Huh? Oh, is it? What is the time complexity over that? Order of n. Each digit in... You are talking about, you store an array, each digit as an array. The order of log n. You have to add... Not even in, and you count it anyway, either bits or number. Digit is order of log n only. That will not work. You have to be efficient. Question is clear? How Python int is represented in a C int internally? That first note on the question, then I'll come. Now how to understand this? First of all, you start opening your brain, then download C Python, capital C Python. Download the source code is available. It's not a very large code base. It's a small code base which anybody can digest it. Large means if I'm talking about 50,000 lines of code or 1 million lines of code. This is small code base, and most of the code base you will say that it's related to what I do in my academics. Most of the things, you can figure it out. Download the C code, spend from morning to evening, just search which are the function doing this stuff. Where this Python int is getting converted into C int, and how Python int is represented in C int, I'll give you a guarantee that's the starting point. You'll start learning it, and then you'll say, it's not a big deal, I can figure it out. However, whoever may be. If you can understand and appreciate C syntax, and you understand how to figure out the flow of the code, you can figure it out. Put a printf, the C code is available, Python, C Python. Put a printf, in whatever the function you say, okay, this function might be doing this one. Suspected. Put a printf, compile that code, run that as a Python, do this stuff, and then see what is happening internally. You will get enlightenment in a day. Which you will not get after studying 4 years of engineering, and if you continue with this stuff and even industry also. Now I'll tell you what happened in industry. You remember this code which we seen it right earlier? These people learned it here. And people don't code by fundamentals, no. People code by patterns. They learn pattern, they fix the pattern. Because code bases are large, when you go in companies and all, 1 million lines of code base, nobody knows that code. Thoroughly. Architecture document is 10 year old. Nobody caring about it. Then you are given a one bug and fixture, then you figure it out which function is doing what, and then you fix the code. Am I clear? And people end up writing this code. Even in Cisco. I was a Cisco employee. Even in Cisco, where IDNs works. Am I clear? And how many places do you use plus function? Everywhere. Plus is the most fundamental operator. Subtraction is also addition only, right? It is everywhere, and people are not writing good code at all. It means what we understood from here. If we are not producing product over here, if you are not doing a open hardware, if you are not doing open software, if you are not doing open system, if you are not doing something interesting and creativity, it means something is lagging, and that is this part. That we are not thorough with fundamentals, and we are not ready to dirty our hands, which is not the case with European and US culture. There people dirty hands. Simple, that's only the difference. You have to dirty your hand, leave your this benches and all. The way you work in hostel, same way, sit down and start working, exploring it. We already got started. Now, next question, similarly. Now, how you create in Python objects, right? Java also create the objects. C++ also create the object. How object gets stored internally? Moment you inherit, how inheritance diagram store internally? This is called a higher level object model, and it's not a hard thing to figure it out. Now what you have to do, this is the next assignment, this is the next level assignment. Download C Python code, Just see how C Python code is actually storing Python object. This A and B what I created in Python, those are Python objects. But internally what it is, C has objects? No. That's a different thing now. What is object? I'll ask later on. But how this Python object get internally represented in a C or in a C Python? That's exercise for you guys. Figure it out. It'll take 2 days. And I give you a guarantee, moment you've done 2 days, you will understand 30% of the C Python code. And you'll feel, I know that where the parser is. I know that where this thing is there. I know this is what doing it. I'll give you a guarantee, you will be automatically motivated. After a week you spend it around, this is holiday work. Holidays are coming now after this. Okay, so get ready for next interesting work, okay? If you want to do something challenging, interesting, over here FOSS community has agreed on, FOSSL has agreed on, that we'll try to adopt some project and they are going to pick up some ideas and all. All those brainstorming we can do here also. What are the problems, let's solve. Let's all of us come tomorrow with the problems and all. We can have a discussion session over here, BOF session, our own, okay? Let's figure it out some of the problem. Corresponding problem, if already people have solved it and there are already some wonderful open source projects are existing, we'll compare them. That's the first assignment. We'll compare them. Okay, after comparing, we'll pick something. Then we'll start contributing in that. This is summer holidays. Okay, internship started. Makes sense, right? And I give you a guarantee, it's not only me. The moment you do something, there are a lot of wonderful people in the world who are ready to jump and help anybody. Provided you've done your work. Provided you've done your work. Now, similarly, I just give you one more example. My net is not over here, the working. If you want to learn a language design, then it's the next third level assignment. Till now what we are learning? Only int, representation, both language, how they deal it. Then next assignment was what? How actually objects are dealt and represented and emulated. That's one. Then same idea, moment you learn in Python, Java is similar, Objective-C is similar, Objective-C and so, somewhere this flavor, that flavor, am I clear? But moment you learn, this is what I want to teach you guys, tell you. Moment you learn the core ideas, believe me, core ideas and fundamentals are ubiquitous, it's everywhere. Am I clear? That's what the design thinking is. Design thinking, am I clear? Moment you start appreciating learning design, it's a similar. Believe me, moment you start going back and see the Java model, it'll take 1 day. If you take it 2 days, then it'll take 1 day. Time will reduce to half. Make sense, right? Okay. Now next assignment I'm giving you, Python language design. Somebody's interested in language design. In my team, no, I had a very wonderful guy. His name was Karthik. It's a joke, okay? I hope you will laugh after this serious discussion. So his name was Karthik and he was a Tamilian, okay? And we had used to always all the wonderful discussion around it. He said, what, yaar? I used to say, yeah, Karthik, I can't understand your language. It's a jalebis. Tamil is like jalebis, right? And Telugu is other way around jalebis. And then he used to say, even I don't understand your language, Hindi. What is like, you know, clothes are hanging on a wire. I never seen Hindi like this. I never felt offended, but you know different perspective we got it. But still, then I used to, interestingly, my all Tamil friends, you know, do the mistake. Khata hai, khati hai, they don't know where the genders are, right? And believe me, they ask me, how come this can be male or this can be female? They ask me, man, even I don't know. Seriously, do you know that, how it is? Nobody knows, right? Even I am searching the guy who introduced the gender in language design. Now you want to understand the language design. I'm posing the next exercise, philosophical idea. Philosophical idea, you want to become philosophical half mad, okay? You want to understand Python language design? There are already PEPs are there, Python enhancement proposals. You search it, I'm giving assignment, okay? There is a with, in Python with the keyword is there, W-I-T-H, with. With keyword is there in Python, okay? Now what do? You go back, search with the PEP. The PEP name is 343. This is a reading assignment for you guys. All of you have to go and read it. It's wonderfully written document. It can't be better than this one. I give you a guarantee. Mumbai, it'll tell you author's perspective, motivation behind this proposal. Okay, what are the use cases are, where it should be used, where it should not be used, and also and so. And then it will talk about a lot of other interesting ideas, and then I'll ask the commentary. That's how the proposal should be. From here, what you will learn? Not only you learn the Python language design, as such, mind will open. You will learn how to write a good proposal. Moment you read the good stuff, see, you want to become awesome. Better badminton player, you have to play with better than you. Right? Can you learn a better game by playing the average player? No, you never. If you want to become better, you have to play with the better. And what is the best way? Play with the betters. Best guys in the world. So these people have designed pragmatic languages. Okay? And you read the document, that will open up your brain to a next level, which is beyond than your books. And believe me, I give you a guarantee, 30% of the document you can understand in first instance, provided you worked on a little bit in Python. And nobody can understand 100% in day one. Believe me, nobody. Okay? It'll take time. Then you go with a lot of questions unanswered. Always carry unanswered question with you. Always be hungry. Einstein, a very interesting statement, I like it. I'm not born intelligent. I have a just idea that I live with the question more. I persist with the question more. So persist with these questions. Carry on open questions always. So open and freedom is not this jazzy word. It's a way of life. It's everywhere. That's the third assignment for you guys. Now next one. How many of you have done Android? Android programming. Very nice. Okay. Now question is this one. You create buttons and all. In Android, what happens? One screen full UI. This is all. How many of you have Android phones? Raise your hands. Okay, all of you. Who has an iPhone? Okay, only few people are rich, huh? Okay. Okay. So now this is your Android phone. Even I have. I carry a cheaper phone, actually. I love to carry cheaper phone only. Okay. Cheap things are awesome. You can break it. Seriously. Now, in Android, what happens, you have one this full screen UI. This screen UI, you make with one component called activity. You create an activity, so like your contact list app. Contacts app is what? You open contact app. You go get what? Contact list. Click on a contact, what happens? You go to one full another screen UI, right? Then you click on a particular contact, then you see what? Contact detail. Then you click on a particular thing, then you dial and phone call happens. Four screen flow is there. How many screen flow is there? Four screen flow. Now, this four screen flow is the same. Oh, very much. Okay, this is the last example, then I'll wind it up. Sorry, yeah. Sorry, guys. So this is the last problem I'm discussing with. Now, this is the same flow, either iOS, Android, Windows Phone, or something else also comes. Even BlackBerry. Same flow. You have four screens UI, and each screen UI, in case of Android, you make with activity. The people who done the Android, right? With activity only we created, right? You create activity, instance of that, and done. Now, with activity you create with the tags, this is button that is, and then you go and write the handler somewhere. But most of the people don't know, moment you click on a button, how handler will get called internally. You know that where to write code and what to write, but you don't know how it works. That's called black box mindset. The tragedy with India's mindset is, we are consumer. We just consume, and we consume in colleges also, we go in company, there also we consume. Yeah, 3 days mein ho jaye fatafat. I get a lot of training assignments, okay? And people say, yeah, 3 days mein train kar do. Maine 3 days mein koi nahi kar sakta train. Nobody can train you in 3 days if you have not done your fundamentals, okay? I'll teach you fundamentals if you are ready to do that. Now, everybody wants to spoon feed them and keep on producing, and that's the mindset is continuing there also. Not here, everywhere. You have to kill that, and one of the best ways you come in FOSS, okay, over here. Now, the question is, you have to understand, moment you click on a button, this is the next exercise, no doubt. Moment you click on a button, how handler get called? How button to handler flow happens? Okay, that's the next assignment. Means, if you try to understand this stuff, you will understand how windowing system works. What do you understand? Windowing system works. You'll understand how windowing system works. Right now you just drag and drop and plug and play, that's it, right? The moment you understand windowing system, opportunities are immense. So, I'm giving you 2 minutes to note down. Now I'll tell you opportunities. Example, how many of you have a smart TV at home? Smart TVs at home. Okay. How many of you like smart TV UI? Okay, how many people say it's a crappy UI? It should be better. It should be better. Okay, how many out of you people like your remote control? Or understand fully remote control? TV remote control. Not even single. Full remote control, right? TV remote control. Over here also one remote control, there are a lot of buttons. That's how the over here engineer mindset is. Engineer mindset is one functionality, one more button. Space is full. Now I have to add one more functionality, make one button toggleable. Then you toggle the other button's functionality and add it. That's a bad design, you know that? Remote control is one of the worst design devices. Apple says very interesting stuff, especially the Jog guy who does the design. Say design should be implicit, it should be obvious, clear. You should not put your brain to understand it. Okay, now what happens in our academic stuff, you never learn design. This pillar part. You learn only production code means developer mindset. You code it. Consume and code as a consumer mindset. You never learn the practitioner approach, which is design approach. And the third approach is the research, okay, which our campus promotes it, even IITs promotes it. But middle part is missing everywhere. Why it is missing? Because there is no flow of people from experience to the industrial experience or a production, you know, practitioner mindset to over here in academic to that side. But that happens in one academics, medicals. In medical, it happens. Whichever the doctor is surgeon, that is also a researcher as well as practitioner. It's a missing gap. Now we can do it. We can solve this problem. Now I'm telling you the problems. What the problem is, you have to understand now windowing system. But how solve that problem, button to handler, how the link happens, you will automatically understand the windowing system. Now what is the implication of it? If you understand windowing system, you can design a windowing system for which a bigger smart TV, better one. Why? Because those windowing systems are designed by whom? These TVs are designed by Samsung, LG and all. And those codes are written by electronics engineer, electrical engineer. And they don't understand design. Their mindset is remote control mindset. One more button. And that's not design. I hope you got it right. It's an unsolved problem. Till now, nobody is solving it. And if you solve it, money is at your desk. You talk in $1 million, it will be there. Another example, I dealt with another client. They had a problem. They do video conferencing solutions. If this is hardly 100 seating capacity or 200 seating capacity. They do video conferencing solutions for 2,000 to 5,000 halls seating capacity and full big TVs. Now, can you construct such a big TV? No. Then you have to combine small TVs, right? In airport and anywhere you say, right? Small display, combined together. Now, this is another assignment I'm giving you. This is really involving one that you have to display whatever you want to display with Android. Now, this company has ported Android for that. Okay, for video conferencing. You have to display what are the bigger picture, like Aishwarya Rai, right? Dancing, hand over there in one screen, leg in another screen and all. That's another interesting exercise. And what the prerequisite for this is? Understanding of windowing system. Okay, so this is I'm telling you. So there are a lot of other interesting stuff is there. With this, I'm closing the talk. Thanks for listening. And anybody has any questions, we are open. I'm available over here. You are free. You are most welcome to ask anything and discuss it. Okay, I'm available.